petition is in his glory. Therefore, I'm here to declare to those of us that have been planting our seeds with him, those of us that have been depositing our seeds with him, those of us that have been laying our treasure with him in heaven, the Holy Ghost tells me to tell you now that in your harvest time. Now, say, neighbor, it is your harvest time. Who the Lord talking to this one? Say, neighbor, it is your harvest time. And you have been graduated from seeding into harvest time. Oh, who the Lord talking to here? Come on, can you just shake hands with 7 or 12 people? Say, neighbor, it is your time now to graduate from seed to seeding. From seeding into harvesting. Somebody say hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. The key in harvesting in the kingdom is not to be confused harvesting with seed. The seed into harvesting in the kingdom is not to be confused with harvesting of seed. You got to separate harvest time or seed time from a harvest. You cannot continue to plant seeds with all harvesting. And there another one is here. Right. Can I repeat that once again? Right. So when I'm talking about harvesting here, I'm not talking about just financial harvesting. I'm not talking about just houses and land. Because during the time of seeding your faith with God, you go through some hard times. Can I repeat that once again? When you are harvesting your faith or seeding your faith with God, oh man, you get pushed around so many times. You get hurt by the devil. You get demonically attacked many times. Because you are exercising your faith, you are seeding your faith and your trust with God, you become entangled in warfare. Is that right? You become entangled in warfare. Yeah, I wonder why Paul said we are like sheep before the slaughter. Right. We have been killed all day long. Because our warfare is not against flesh and blood, but spiritual wickedness. Is that right? No matter how many victory you receive, but why in the battle? Why in the battle, the front of the fight? Why on the battlefield? You get wounded so many times. You get wounded. You get hurt. You get attacked so many times. You get confused so many times. And when God graduates you from your seed time of faith, and he brings you into his glory, he brings you into his harvest, he do not just pull down harvest of material things upon you. He also pull down harvest of healing in your body. Put down harvest of deliverance for your problem. Somebody said you get to receive your harvest. Remember, you've been through a lot. This is your time for your harvesting of good health. This is your time for your harvesting of happiness. This is your time for your harvesting of joy. Come on, shout and praise the Lord. happiness. This is my harvest time. Can someone shout, say glory to God? Oh, come on, put your hands together. Let the devil flee from you.
Freedom. I'm moving out in my healing. I'm moving out in my deliverance.
My healing is in the glory. My delivery is in the glory. My promotion is in the glory. My victory is in the glory. I can't hear it. Glory to God. My victory is in the glory. My healing. My delivery. Say neighbor. My seed time. My seed time. I'm paying up. I'm being with God. Say neighbor. I thank God for planting seed with him. Oh, you don't get it. You don't get it. You don't get it. You don't get it. Get into the spiritual realm and see yourself going above your grasp. See yourself rising above your grasp. See yourself rising above your enemies. See yourself being the head, not the tail. See yourself being the boss, not the knee. Being above, not believe. It's free time. It is my harvest time. It is my harvest time. As long as the earth remains, there will always be seed time and harvest. See yourself in harvesting. You see, during seed time, a lot of people are not happy. Because it's a lot of works. Is that right? It's a lot of works. You got to cultivate the ground, dig the ground to put the seed in. But in harvest time, you don't have to dig no ground. Is that right? In harvest time, oh my goodness. All you got to do is just go about plucking the ears of the corns. Plucking, you can. Extend your hands and the corn comes in your hands. Because it's harvest time. In the harvest time, you go shopping. Seed time, you don't shop well. But harvest time, you shop.
Yes.
When your crop is good, right?
Yes, Lord.
Oh, say, neighbor, I got some good crops. Because God bless me with them. So who the Lord talking to this morning? Because the harvest time in your life, God bless the God breathe the spirit of increase on your harvest. He breathe the spirit of increase on your harvest. To keep the locusts away. God breathe the spirit of protection upon your harvest. To keep the tear away. Is that right? Somebody say, neighbor, I have a good harvest. Because of good God. A merciful God. A compassionate God. Is the one that blesses me. For with the increase. The increase of my harvest. Say, neighbor, expect increase in your harvest. Expand your territory. Expand your territory. Expand your tents. Because there are more harvest coming. There are spirit of increase on your harvest. Increase are upon you to increase your harvest. Increase your blessing. To increase your blessing. To increase your blessing.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, glory to God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, glory to God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Not because.
Thank you, Jesus.
Not because. Not because the previous, not because the previous occupier or person that occupied that position had a bad harvest. That doesn't mean that you are that person. Can I repeat that once again? not because the previous person that will occupy that position that God has given you. We're not successful.
Thank you, Jesus.
With a good harvest. That doesn't mean that you are that person. That doesn't mean that you will go through that same situation. There was a reason that God changed the guy. There was a reason that God changed the leadership. There was a reason that God brought you into that position.
Jesus.
Who the Lord are people here?
God
has a way of setting one down and promoting the others.
Yes.
I didn't believe us here.
Yes.
I didn't believe us here.
Yes, Lord.
So the God that gave you that position in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
The God that elevated you to that place. Somebody say, in that place.
In that place.
The problem with the previous leader, God was there all the time, but that leader did not recognize the God that was there.
That's right. Amen.
But saying you recognize that God is there with you.
Amen.
Oh, who the Lord talking to?
Jesus, thank you, Lord.
Saying you recognize that God is the one that gave you that place. Saying you invite His presence to be with you there all the time. Saying you are consistently worshiping and serving Him. Saying you are consistently hungry to be in your assignment that He places upon your life. You are still on your post. I'm taking you somewhere. As I say, every now and then, that every anointing has its followers. Say you have discovered that it is God's will that you should be under that anointing. Say you have discovered that it is God's will to bring you under that anointing. And you recognize that anointing. You recognize the vessel that is carrying that anointing. You recognize the vessel that God has set aside, that your blessing will come through. When you continue to be faithful to that assignment, say, neighbor, be faithful to that assignment. Oh, glory to God. As long as you are faithful to your assignment where God placed you, you will always have the increase of your harvest.
Thank you, Jesus.
Ask the woman, the widow woman. That was when Elijah.
That's right.
Ask Oprah of Psalm of 1 Samuel chapter 2, chapter 4. She invested with the man of God. As long as you continue to take care of God's business, God will take care of you.
Amen.
The conclusion of the whole matter. Say, neighbor, as long as you continue to take care of God's assignment and God's business, you will never lack nothing. You will never lack anything. God will always provide your increase.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
I dare witness you here.
Yes.
God will always give you that increase. God will always send you the people to work with you.
Yes,
Jesus. He said, I will take of your spirit.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, you're not honoring your. That's some of the mystery of God.
Yes, Lord.
God said, I will take of your spirit and place it upon those that are working with you.
Thank you, Lord.
And they will cooperate with you.
Yes.
Because they will understand you because your spirit is upon them.
Yes, Lord.
Your spirit is upon them. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So, at the initial state, people will test you. But give it a few months. Yeah, be patient and give it a few months. And God started to bring the people that He has chosen to be with you.
Amen.
And he started to put your spirit upon them. But you will have to continue with the assignment.
Yes, amen.
Take care of my business, I will take care of you. Take care of my house and I will take care of you. Go in my vineyard and work. And whatsoever that is right, I will pay. Whatsoever. I still have more blessing in store for you. With your name written on them. In his glory, you don't have to work. You just say, ask and seek and knock my door. In his glory, you don't do it. He do it for you.
Yes, Lord. Jesus.
Say, neighbor, your future is in the glory.
It's in the glory. Ooh, thank you, Lord. Ooh. Thank you, Jesus.
It's not always in your faith.
Thank you, Jesus.
Your faith can get tired sometimes.
Yes.
Your faith can be frustrated sometimes.
Thank you, Jesus.
As I said from at the beginning of the message, sometimes you have the faith, but you don't have the tools to work out the faith.
Yes, Lord.